Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is Andre from Dagubi. Today I'm going to show you how to make three different tree branches. So please create a new document, go to File and click New. So I use for this tutorial 340 millimeters for the width, 210 millimeters for the high, and I use color mode RGB. Click create. So the first thing what we need is a simple brush. So please choose the polygon tool and click on your artboard. So we need 8 millimeters for the radius and we need three sides. Click OK. And now rotate this, go to the corner and rotate this for 90 degrees. Hold down the shift key and rotate this two times. And now change the color, none color for stroke and black color for fill. So choose the selection tool and move this shape to the left side and scale the right side, drag this like this. So next you have to smooth the left anchor points. So select both points and now drag this little dots a little bit so that's fine. And now I'm going to create a brush from this shape. So you have some options to do this. First option is click on this button, new brush, or you can go to the brushes panel options and click new brush, or you can choose the selection tool and move, drag this shape into the brushes panel. So I'm going to create an art brush, click OK, and now change the options, enable scale proportionately, and change the colorization method to tints and click OK. So you can delete this brush and now I'm create a line. So this is my brush. So in this tutorial I work only with the mouse, so please open the paintbrush tool options, make a double click on the paintbrush tool, and I prefer this position and click OK. So now I start with the branch. So next, select the whole line and now choose the direct selection tool and select the inner points and convert these points to corner. Click on this button on the toolbar at the top and now create more lines. Choose again the paintbrush tool and deselect all. So, and again, select the inner anchor points. So when you choose the paintbrush tool, you can hold down the control key and click on this line and select all this path. So if you wish, you can delete some of these points Choose the Delete Anchor Point tool. So again, choose the Paintbrush tool and create a line. So select the line, hold down the Control key and click on this path. So you can hold down the Control key and drag your mouse, or you can delete this path and now hold down the Shift key and select, for example, this point to deselect this point. And now go and click on this button, convert selected anchor points to corner. And when, if you wish, you can delete some of these points. So if you wish, you can change the stroke width. So select the path and now go and change the stroke width. So that's fine. So you can change the stroke width in very small steps. So hold down the Control key and click on this arrow. So you can add more points. So I'm going to select this path and now choose the Add Anchor Point tool and click on this position. So select this point and convert this anchor point to smooth. Or you can hold down the Alt key and you can drag this handle. So I'm finished with the branch. Okay, next you have to expand the branch. So select the whole group, click on this little circle, or you can go and click select all. And now go to objects and click expand appearance. So next you have to apply an effect. So, but first go to view and click choose hide edges, checked in. And now go to effect, distort and transform, and choose roughen. So enable the preview. This is too much. So change the size to 0.1. Change the points to smooth and change the detail to 7. So, but these are too small. So it's very important to simplify this path. So go to object, path, and choose simplify. So you can try different settings. So I prefer 97% and click OK. So hide again the edges and now open the appearance panel. So you find the appearance panel here and click on this effect, roughen, and enable the preview. And now you can try again. So I think 0.2 is okay. So show edges, and I'm going to move these points. Okay, that's fine. Select all and go to object and click expand appearance. Oh, sorry. Undo expand appearance. First, you have to go to Pathfinder and unite all these shapes. Click on this button, unite. So next, if you wish, you can change some of these corners. So select this point and drag this little circle. So after unite, you can check again the roughen effect. So next I'm going to create some leaf brushes. Okay, before I start with my leaf brushes, it's important to expand this branch. So select the whole group, click on this little circle, and now go to Object and click Expand Appearance. So next, choose the ellipse tool and create an oval like this. So check the color, black color for fill and none color for stroke. And now choose the direct selection tool and select the left point and the right point and convert both points to corner. Go to the toolbar at the top and click on this button, convert selected anchor points to corner. And now select these two center points and move these points to the left. And next choose the rectangle tool and create a small rectangle. So next, choose the selection tool and select both shapes and go to the toolbar at the top and choose align to selection and click on this button, vertical align center. So next, choose the direct selection tool and select these two points of the rectangle shape and convert these two points to smooth. Next, you have to make a copy of this leaf. So select both shapes and drag this down. But you have to do this by holding down the Alt key. And now move the rectangle to the right. It's fine. And now make a copy of both leaves. Pull down the Alt key and drag this down. Next, select only this second leaf and rotate this little bit and shrink this leaf. So make a copy again, hold down the Alt key and drag this down. Next, go to the transform panel and flip the sleeve vertical. So if you wish, you can rotate second leaf. And now we need again two copies. Select only these three leaves and hold down the Alt key and drag this down. And next, press Ctrl key and D for a second copy. And now delete this leaf and this leaf. So if you wish, you can rotate this again to make more variations. So, and last, select all leaves and open the Pathfinder and click on this button, Unite. So now it's time to convert all these leaves to brushes. So choose the selection tool, select. So you can ungroup this leaves, or you can use the group selection tool to select these leaves. So I prefer to choose the group selection tool. So select this leaf, and now you have some options to create brushes. So one option is click on this little button into the brushes panel. New brush, or you can go to the brushes panel options and click new brush, or you can drag the sleeve into the brushes panel. So this time I convert this to an art brush, click OK and change the options. Choose scale proportionately and change the colorization method to tints and the direction. This button, it's okay. So make the same with the second brush, art brush, scale proportionately, tints, okay. So choose a paintbrush tool and try the leaves. So these two brushes, you have to move these brushes after drawing. The reason is the center line. So it's no options to change this. So every time you draw this with these brushes, you have to move these brushes. So in the next few minutes, I'm going to draw the leaves. Okay, next I recommend you to group all the sleeves. So open the layers panel and select all the sleeves layer. And now open layers panel options and choose collect a new layer. So if you wish, you can change the color of the leaves to green and the color of the branch in brown. Oh, sorry, not the stroke color. You have to choose the fill color. So, but I prefer to make both groups in black. And next I'm going to create two other branches. So the next thing what we need to do is expand all the leaf brushes. So please select all, go to select and click all. Now go to object and click on expand appearance. So next, please choose your favorite branch. So I like this second branch and I arrange this, I move this on top. So this is my basic branch and the second branch. And this is my last branch. So now I'm going to change the color. So first I use this three colors. So I choose my third branch and change the fill color to yellow. The second branch to orange and the third branch to dark orange. So next, select all. And now hide the edges, go to view and choose hide edges. So next I use the recolor artwork. You can find this in the toolbar at the top, or you can go to edit, edit colors and choose recolor artwork. So click on this edit button and click on this button, link harmony colors, and now you can change the color. So first make this darker, so, or you can go and change the single color. So another option is you can choose the swatches library, open the swatches and open the swatch libraries menu, choose nature and I choose seasons and I use this last group. So first select this first branch and I apply this color for the fill color. Now select the second branch and choose the other color and dark green color. So if you wish, you can move these branches. And you can scale these branches a little bit. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.